battle! Joker! Kushina!
Two?
I'm sick. All right. Wait, who's Zalos? Is he the other TO? Gotcha. That's why he's on. Okay. So I haven't seen how the rest of the game has went, but I'm just jumping in now. Well, hey, man. Oh, because you heard him. Okay. So this matchup. On the low is actually probably even. I don't know how people think about it, like, in general, but I think that, like, Joker has all the tools to get around Lucina's hitboxes, but he does get outranged by Lucina's hitboxes. So, like, yeah, that's basically how I feel about the matchup. And actually, Joker being one of the only characters in the game who can, like, consistently edgeguard Lucina with the guns down. And his counter is the only counter in the game that actually worked against Lucina's up B. Because Tetrakarn is ridiculous. That's actually a really good combo starter. I don't see a lot of Jokers doing, like, at top level, but I see it a lot here. Down air into grab. It's just a true combo. It's really, really good. And, like, it's easy to tell which way they're going to go off the dare. It's always in front of the Joker. So, like, it's very easy to get that grab when you get really low percent combos with Joker, which are always great. Okay, so if he can get a big use of this Arsene, because it's possible that he'll die without getting Arsene again, I think he has to make use of the one he has right now. And down throw, he doesn't DI in, so that fair is not true. Dash attack's gonna be big though, he has no jump, so he's gonna go off there. Yeah, he has no jump, so he just dies. He went for the back air, I think would have caught like an early RB, but I like where that the back air was placed, because if he air dodged in and then held all the way in, he wouldn't have been able, he might have been able to make that back because he, like, had to hesitate because the back air would have hit him. He was too far away to recover. So even if he did, like, recognize that he had no jump there and, like, drift properly and then up properly, I think he was going to die anyway because of where that bear was placed. So that was actually... It's more like edgeguarding based off of where you are than, like, what move you do. He didn't hit him with anything, but, like, he edgeguarded based on positioning, which is actually really good. And Joker's really good at it, so... Because, like, he could gun down at any time. He could counter at any time. And, like, you don't want to hit any of those. Or he could just go for, like, a back air. And then that also sucks. So, like, he has a ton of options that, like, you want to be afraid of when he's coming out to get you. And Oceana, while having a good recovery, kind of a linear pattern back to... Okay. Croker's always with bad. So, kind of has, like, a linear path to come back. She only really has a double jump and an up B. She, like, could stall with, like, the side B a little bit, but she doesn't get as much distance if she does that. And she could counter if she, like, breathes one of your options when you're coming out to get her. But other than that, she has no real options. I like this narrow play at the edge right now. That B reverse Shieldbreaker puts him at a good position to back here, but he actually doesn't opt to go for it. I don't know why, like, what's the point of that Shieldbreaker if not to go for the back air? That fair was a little bit greedy. I think he could have just landed with, like, a nair there just to get back to stage. Now he's out of Arsene. And that first Arsene is different than the next two Arsenes. Because, like, the Arsene on your first stock, the Arsene meter starts at zero. So Arsene comes at around, like, 80 to 100. Oh, he's dead off that. Wow. Max rage, or not max, but a ton of rage on that. That's actually going to make that kill. But, yeah, the next two Arsenes will come at around 60, something like that. But for the first one, I mean, this is assuming you don't get any Arsene meter and you're not, like, camping them out, like, a ton. The first one, though, is probably the only one you're going to get unless you get counters. Just like, look, he's already at 160 and he still has only had one Arsene, and he's going to die off that, yeah. It's a bad feeling to die to Lucina up B. Because you... Oh, wow. I like that. Recognize he doesn't have a jump, and this air is going to pop him far enough out that he can't do anything. That was actually really good. Nair, to grab, gets enough air. Oh, goes for a re-grab? Maybe he meant to do something else in the air. Down throw, up air, up tilt. It's not true, but it's really hard to get out of. Because you don't want to smash air dodge in Lucina's frame traps, because he's really good at catching that. I like that up air. Like, he goes for the fair. I like that he did it twice in a row. He does, like, a short hop fair to try to get him, and then does the up air on the way down, just in case that didn't hit. This is scary. I'm just going to be an 82 at the ledge. You're going to die with a couple things from Arsene, which is really, really early. I like that fair. That was really good. Just run out of the fair. He's in a terrible position. He has no more Arsene. So, oh, that Arsene being gone actually kind of helped him out. It made his recovery harder to hit. I think that's what he needed right there. So he's definitely not out of this game if he can take the stock soon. But either way, he's not going to... Oh, he fell out of that nether. That would have killed F-Tilt. Not killing either. If he doesn't get Arsene, which he probably won't. I mean, he's actually pretty close, but he probably won't. Then I don't see him killing him unless he gets, like, a first hit fair up air, drag down stuff. Out B the other way. It's really good punish out of shield. And now 108. He's not afraid of dying yet to just Joker unless he gets, like, an edge guard. But he's already tacked on a ton of percent, and now you're very close to Arsene. And now that I talk about that, though, he's at 130. You're now going to die to some Joker things. Regular Joker. You don't need the big brother. He'll now die to, like, a back air at the ledge. Oh, now Arsene. Okay, now a ton of things are going to start killing. It's just a matter of catching one or two of them. No throws yet, though. That's in a bad... If you're dying to Joker grab and you're against an Arsene, you're in a bad spot. Right now, back air. F-Tilt's definitely going to take it. Yep, that's definitely going to be it. And that is... I don't remember his tag. What's his name? Dala? Zalos. Taking it over username. Oh, I'm on stream next. I'm against Aaron. Overrated video, by the way.
Pokemon Trainer.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, sorry. Oh, wow. Sheik Bayo. This is a throwback. Sheik Bayo. It's been a hot minute since I have seen this matchup. These characters both have a hard time killing. I'm not going to pretend like I know what the matchup is, like who wins, who loses, who does better in what stage, whatever. What I am going to say is, I know that Bayo's combos do a lot more damage than Sheik's, and she probably still doesn't need... Like, she needs less neutral wins in order to take a stock than vice versa. Not as bad as the last game. Like, the last game, she could win neutral 100 times, and then Bayo wins it once, and that's it. It's not that bad, but I can definitely say for certain that she needs less wins than she in neutral. That being said, I don't know Agua. I don't know if he's like new here or if anything like that. Wait, did he make an upset? Because this is winners round three. Did he make an upset here? Huh? Oh, really? It's out of seed. Do you know Agua? Okay, so he's top 8'd Encore before once. I haven't heard of him, but that doesn't mean that he's not good. Oh, they play together. That sucks. So, actually, that's interesting. I want to hear what they think of the matchup after this is over, because if they play a lot, they must know. They must have a preference. So, that weak Nair at this percent, because he's got all this rage. Oh, he might be dead from this. Oh my god. Okay, yeah. F tilt up air, gonna kill at like 80%, which you don't usually see happening to Sheik ever. Usually because she can't get that high with the max rage, but Bayonetta allowing her to get there. Dang. 193, we're still not killing, huh, Bayo? Alright. You do you. Whatever. He keeps much timing, no. Bats withinning out of everything. I think that was a dead cross up. I do not think that would have killed if he did it right. I could be wrong, though. After not connecting fully because Bayonetta's not a functional character. Two up airs, not gonna do. Wow, two up airs did like 6 damage. That, I mean, obviously it wasn't the full up air, but still, that is pathetic. So I think the play, because he keeps bats withinning out of these combos, right? I think maybe he's gonna start adapting a little more and like, because he's mashing air dodge, right? To get. Oh, she chases him, but he doesn't get it. Yeah, but I think we're gonna see him waiting for the air dodge on a couple of these things for potentially big punishes, like a charge, down smash, or something like that. Might be big. Ooh, I like that up smash. So far, the Sheik threatening to kill much earlier than the Bayonetta. I mean, of course, you got that crazy platform confirmed at like 80, which wouldn't normally happen, but even that up smash right there almost taking it out. Wow, he just cannot get any of these F tilt up airs to hit. He keeps bats withinning out of everything. That's got to be frustrating. Again, he did it on his shield. That's crazy. Bayo's crazy. I mean, she's not, but like... Yeah, see? That's kind of what I meant. He did the F-tilt, and then he waited for the air dodge option to try to get the F-smash. Unfortunately, Bayonetta is a skinny character, so getting her with an F-smash on her landing, even when she's not doing much, still kind of tricky. Oh, he dared him! Oh, he has two of these left. Okay, I thought he had one, and then he was going to die. He traded with that dare. He would have landed on stage anyway, but like the trade was really good for him. Yeah, so he's been air dodging out all these combos, and I feel like Og was catching on. But like he's just not... Like, he's not positioning himself to catch the directional air dodges. And I get it. Sheik's stubby in this game. But, like, you have the reads.
Oh, a gas attack's going to kill?
Yeah, that is. That is going to blow him up, for sure. So even with that big F tilt up there confirmed on the platform, kill him very early. For the rest of the game, Bayonetta killed it easier than Sheik. After he got that the down throw kill on the first dog, he then got a dash attack kill and a forward smash kill, if I'm not mistaken. Which both didn't kill that late. The dash attack was at like 160, which is like, for Bayonetta, not bad. Dash smash is at like 120, which is very good for him. Is he going to change characters? Maybe he's tired of these combos like not working. Now, I can't blame him. It's got to be annoying to be like, oh, time to frame trap my opponent. Oh, they battled in. That sucks. Pichu, character with much better kill power. And his combos are much more real and true. His combos are much more real and true, so he can't actually air dodge or batch the out of them as much. If you want to play the Pichu game, Bayonetta, all about it. Because if Pichu keeps doing damage to himself or herself or whatever, then Bayonetta might actually get a kill. He read that. Yeah, that's a big thing. Usually when like a Pikachu is like quick attacking back to stage, you have to like respect the hitbox. Pichu obviously doesn't have that. So if you think that he's gonna quick attack in, just throw out a thing. If it doesn't work, what's the worst of the thing that's gonna happen? You're not gonna hit by that quick attack, it's fine. He's playing really well around Pichu right now, which is hard as Bayonetta. I can't imagine this is in her favor. Yeah, I don't think Agua wants to camp very much. I think he sees why that's a bad idea. And he's like, you know what? I'm going to throw out a couple T-Jolts, but then I'm going to go back to running at you. And Airways is aware of that. He's like, all right, I just won't approach them. And I think, oh, the Thunder came out. You know, he only sucks because these guys play a lot. They're homies. He taunts. He's like, I don't respect your taunt. Screw your taunt. And then he battles things out of a combo and gets his own combo. That's just the dirtiest exchange. Yeah, so he went down to Thunder to try to kill him really early and just killed himself super duper early, which sucks. RCO lag, only gets an up air forward because bats within again out of everything. Thunder wouldn't have killed, but it would have done a lot of damage and would have put the fear god into him. Dash attack. Pichu looked so happy. He dash attacked the witch time, and Pichu was like, yeah! And then he got a fist in his face. That's gotta hurt. Ice and KV. Yeah, okay. That's one of the only matchups in the game where like Bayonetta can actually kill, because obviously Pichu's the lightest character in the game, the easiest to kill. So killing wasn't as much of a problem, and they didn't need to worry about camping at all. So like, that's why that happened. But on this other side, we got Ice and Kraveen. Kraveen, I know he comes here. I know that he's here a lot. I don't know who he plays. And I feel bad. I am just so bad at names. Who does Kraveen play? Who does Kraveen? Mario. I knew that. I did know that. No, I didn't. Who am I lying to? So Mario Joker, most likely. Gotta say, from both ends, that is an annoying matchup. I do think Joker has the edge in this, though. Mario is not equipped with that many tools to really hit grappling hook. Like, he can maybe get, like, a weak nair, and that's the threateningest thing he has. Okay, I can't think of anything else. Like, unless you go really, really deep with, like, a back air, but, like, you don't want to... That's, like, the best moves at hitting grappling hook last a long time, or they're a multi-hit move. So like, I don't know, Pika Bear. Joker. Mario. Yo, what's up? Ow. What? That's fun. But I thought, well, he kept going for a challenge, so that actually makes sense. Anyway, though. Yeah, like we thought, Joker, Mario. Mario cannot fireball camp at all. Joker can camp like hell in the catch-up. He doesn't care about... He can't cape guns. Because guns are like the bullet arts. That's also a threat constantly to being like making sure your combos are airtight with the Rebel's gun. There it is. There's the big brother now. And he's off stage. Actually, one thing in this matchup I forgot about until just now. It is incredibly easy to two-frame Arsene, and Mario's dash attack is like super good at it. You can just get up attack, or you can just dash attack the edge, and I guarantee you it's going to hit the Arsene up B if he goes to ledge 100% of the time. And if he goes over, whatever, you just punish him after. Thanks, Nick. Thanks for ruining my commentary. I was commentating the match, telling the people about matchup, and you were like, so thanks for that.
Anyways, welcome to myself.
Wow.
It is I, Nogu.
I actually hate Nogu. What was that? Oh, wow.
Anyway.
Fireball stopped his horizontal momentum.
So, this is game one, right?
Yes, it's game one. Look at the score, Nick.
Well, I thought I saw Ice playing here before.
Wow.
What? Okay, he actually could have gotten cheesed out right there.
He died off that? He died?
Yeah, man.
I like that down tilt. It didn't work, but I like it.
Now, wait, so when do Joker loops start working?
What do you mean?
Like the down throw, up air, down throw.
That's
like...
not real. Down throw, up air, drag downs are not real unless you're huge.
Okay.
Up throw is real.
Oh,
and those end at like 20.
Okay.
Anything beyond that, you'd be out like a caveman.
Yeah, okay. Anyway.
So he has no jump. He's dead. Yep. You're just dead. Yep.
Hey. Doesn't down throw back air work?
Why aren't you there? Why aren't you down there? Yeah, I mean, I would have down right there. Bobo would have down right there.
I would have down it right there.
No, you wouldn't have. No, you wouldn't have.
I would have nothing down there.
No, you wouldn't have.
Yes, I would.
You would have back aired. You would have back aired. That's what you would have done.
Ivysaur,
no. You would have back aired there. With Joker, you would have. Brian's like, I would have SD'd.
No, I'm talking about like after he can't recover.
Yeah, after he can't recover, you would have back aired because you're a pansy.
No.
Yes.
What the fuck?
What the heck? Oh wait, no, this
no,
is not
it's
UD.
Encore.
It's not UD.
Yeah, so what the fuck?
Yeah, he had two subs anyway, it's fine. I would have killed myself with an up air to bring him back, just to come back to an F smash. Nick would have IV'd aired him. Somehow. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Running right back. I don't think it's a bad idea. I think it's not the stage. You just got unfortunately ganked there at the end. I think he was putting up a good fight.
I can find Mario being kind of good on PS2. Like if they ban Triplash, like
yeah, like you still get the ladders on this stage at times. Smash was probably a little better for it, but I don't not like this pick. Yeah, you can't get anything off an up air at zero, and Joker can just commit to a Rebel's Guard if you try to do anything. Down throw F tilt? Okay.
It's crazy how like good of like a combo breaker Rebel's Guard is.
It's so good. It's like Grand 3, it's really, 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 really solid. Of course, if you read it or if you react to it, you get a big punish, but like.
Eh. Yeah. Oh, that's a bad recovery.
Well, I know why he did it though. Yeah, Ice is content to be like, I'm gonna shoot these guns and shoot these Aegons. I don't need to approach.
Yeah, he cares about
all the Pokemon for 1 billion lives.
Alright, this debate is actual trash. Pokemon will win so free, it's unbelievable. And it's not even.
I don't know, it's a billion.
Max Ketchum's an idiot. Max Ketchum's an idiot. Oh, the lion ladders. The lion ladders. Okay, listen to this. Garantina just goes into an alternate dimension. What do the lions do?
So Garantina is being a bitch. Today.
He's camping, yeah.
He's camping.
He's camping. Okay, why does he lose?
Because the lions have more people, therefore they
come out. That's not how that you.
Yeah, the lions have more stocks.
No, Garantina comes in, throws out a shadow ball, kills a couple of them, and then goes back.
So we got a billion, so
Okay, you come in, you kill a couple, you go back. You come in, you kill a couple, you go back. Until you die.
Anyways, Ice looks like it's about to end the game.
It's a billion, I know, and a billion's a big number. We all get this. However, it doesn't matter because Dialga is literally the god of time. He can just go back in time if they're ever close to losing. Kill him first. How are Lions killing Dialga? How? Bite his head off. Bite his head off. It's made of steel. It's made of steel. Okay. What is that?
I'm just trying to talk about the match because he's.
he says if each takes a bite, you get 1 billion bites, which is plenty. That's the dumbest argument I've ever heard in my entire life. If you have 100 people punch a boulder, it's not gonna break. It's still a boulder. No, it doesn't. No one's gonna be able to break that. It's if you have 100 Dwayne the Rock Johnsons, you're still fucked. You're still fucked.
Nothing to tech, so
by the way, you didn't update the score, Ryan. You're a trash TO. Huh? Now? Alright, we're up.
Oh, God.
The Pokemon.
Go! Pokemon Trainer.
Now.
battle. Link. Pokemon Trainer.
Battle! Pokemon Trainer!
One, go!
Yeah. Come on. Thank you. Let's go.
winner, Pokemon Trainer.
Huh. Ascend! Thank you.
battle. Start battle. Pokemon Trainer.
Three, two, one, go! Yeah. Thank you. Hey! Thank you. Oh!
battle. Joker.
Go! Let's go. Great, huh?
One, go!
Banjo and Kazooie! Joker!
Set! Thank you. Uh-huh.